Hey everyone, welcome back to the Azure Data Factory session. In this session, I'm going to show you how do we use a filter activity in our pipelines. Okay, normally when will we be using this filter activity is you have an array, be it an integer array or an array of file names. It can be any type of array, okay, and you want to filter a specific value, specific set of values based on some conditions. For example, if it is an integer array, right, you want to filter those numbers which are greater than 3. Similarly, if it is file names of file names array, right, you want to filter those file names which end with which ends with .txt or .csv. So something like that, if you want to do in an Azure Data Factory pipeline, right, you can go for a filter activity. Okay, so today what we are going to do is we have a blob path created. Okay, in this blob path, as you are seeing here, right, we have two text files and one XLSX file. So what we are going to do from our Azure Data Factory pipeline is we are going to just filter out the text files. We don't want XLSX file. So what we have to do is we have to filter out these text files and do a copy activity. Okay, so go back to adf.azure.com and then I'm going to use a get metadata activity. So this is an activity which is very helpful if you want to get the file names inside a specific folder in the blob storage path. Okay, so if you want to know more about get metadata activity, please watch my earlier videos wherein I have explained it clearly. Okay, so get files, I'm just renaming it. So data set, I already have created an input data set. If you want to see how to create a data set for blob storage, you please watch my earlier videos. Okay, so this is nothing but if you open this, it will be pointing to fsadf, which is my container name, and it is the folder name inside which we have the files I showed you before. Okay, fsadf and sa underscore demo. Okay, so this is what my data set is pointing to. Okay, so I'm not going to make any change. As you can see here, right, the file name is empty because we just want to read all the files, file names, and filter out the required files. Okay, so this get metadata activity is going to give us the list of file names, but it doesn't work without we choosing a field list. So we have to choose something called child items. So only then it will be giving us the details of the file. Okay, what is the file name and what is the type of the object. Okay, so after this activity is getting executed, right, you will be getting the list of files, which is nothing but these three files. Okay, so now we have to use a filter activity. So filter activity always works in an array. So it just needs an array as input. Okay, so filter text files, I'll just rename it text files. Okay, go to settings. We just need two things. One is input array, second is the condition to filter. Okay, items will be nothing but those records or file names which is brought by the get files, get metadata activity. Okay, so in get metadata activity, this child items is going to give you the details of files, okay, or array of files. All right, so here the condition will be very simple. So what we have to do is we are just going to extract those files which end with, or which those files which are having an extension .txt. So what we can do is we can use a string function called ends with function. Okay, so this ends with function takes two parameters. One is a string input and second is the string to be searched for. Okay, so in our case it's going to be text. Okay, we are interested to filter out the file names which are ending with txt. Okay, so what is going to be the string? It is nothing but the current item. Just type item dot name. Our get metadata activity, right, it is going to bring you two things, two details. One is the name of the file, second is the type of the file. Okay, name of the object and type of the object. So in our case it's going to be the first name of the file is 123 or 0123.txt. So it's going to be 0123.txt. this is the object name, and type of the object is file. So similarly, you are going to get three details from get metadata activity. I'll show you that while I execute this pipeline. Okay, so this name property is the one which we will be looking at. So this is what we are using here. So item dot name, it should end with the txt. So that's all. So now that is all with respect to the design of the pipeline. So I'll just validate it quickly and then I will debug it. So validation is good. So let's all run this. So the pipeline has finished execution. So as I told you, right, if you look at the output of the get metadata activity, it is bringing the details of objects present in the folder with two details. I mean, one is name of the object, second is type of the object. So type is important because the folder might contain subfolders as well. So that time it will be directory or folder. So it is bringing us three records. Okay. So when you see 0123.txt and then xlsx file and then again a txt file. So get metadata activity is bringing three files which are present in my folder. So what this particular filter text file is doing? So it's taking the input from the get files activity and then it has filtered out based on the condition we have given. So if you look at the output, the total items were 3 and filtered items are 2. And if you look at the value, right, it's just a filtering out the text files. Okay. So you can use this output in subsequent activities to either copy or delete or move or whatever you want to do it, right? Load to a table, you can do anything subsequently. So this is how we use a filter activity to filter out a specific set of values from a given array. Alright, so I think I made it clear. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section, and I request you to subscribe to my channel because that is going to motivate me. Okay, thanks a lot. Thanks for watching. Keep supporting.